Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep. In this video series, we are talking about indifference curve analysis for the advanced segment. In the previous video, we talked about price consumption curve for given goods. This video shall focus upon income consumption curve. To understand what income consumption curve is, it is mandatory that you understand what income effect is in the first place and how income varies with normal and inferior goods. If you don't understand any of that, then you may not be able to figure out anything that I'm teaching in this particular session. So the link for income effect would be available in the description box. So please take a look at that first before you come on this video. So without wasting any time further, let's get started. Now, income consumption curve would refer to a graphical representation that would show how a consumer is changing his consumption of two goods given a change in their income, keeping the prices of both the commodities constant. Before we move on to the slope of ICC curve, a quick recap. When we talk about income and its relationship with various types of commodity, you should be aware that we are focusing in terms of normal goods and inferior goods. And we should also remember that income varies directly with normal goods and inversely with inferior goods. Based on that relationship, we have the slope of ICC curve. So the slope of ICC curve is technically broadly categorized into positive or negative. So when we talk about positive, it happens when both the commodities listed on the X and the Y axis are normal goods. And when we talk about negative, then in that case, either the commodity listed on the x-axis is an inferior good or the commodity listed on the y-axis is an inferior good. We'll look at a diagrammatic representation of each of these three. Let's take a look. The first thing that we will take a look at is positive ICC curve. And this is how the diagram would look like. We'll build up upon this. On the y-axis, we have good y. On the x-axis, we have good x. AB is the budget line. IC is the initial indifference curve with equilibrium as E, which is the initial equilibrium. Now, when the income of a consumer increases, his budget line would shift outwards or it would shift to the right, which is in this direction. Okay, let's do that. Let us say this is his new budget line now. A1, B1. Ideally, it is supposed to be parallel. If it doesn't look parallel on my iPad, on your books, if you're drawing along with me, make sure that you make it parallel to AB. All right. Now, when a consumer's income increases, he is now capable of buying more of both the commodities. In that case, he should be probably somewhere around here on the new budget line. Let us say this is the new indifference curve, which is IC1, tangent at E1, which is the new equilibrium. If the income of consumer increases again, his budget line would again shift outwards. Let us name it as A2, B2. Again, the consumer would be at a higher indifference curve now because the income has gone up, his ability to buy both the goods has increased. Let us say this is the new equilibrium at IC2, which is E2. Now, one thing that we need to remember is at point E, a consumer was buying, let us say, OY quantity of good Y and OX quantity of good X. However, as his income increased, his ability to buy both the commodities went up. So he increased his consumption of good Y from Y to Y1 and of good X from X to X1. Likewise, in case of budget line A2, B2, again, he is able to buy more of good Y and good X. Now, when we join all these pointers, the equilibrium points, we get an upward sloping curve. This is the ICC curve. It is an upward sloping curve, What does that indicate? It indicates that the consumer is increasing his purchases of both the commodities simultaneously. When will this happen? When both the goods, both X and Y, are normal goods. So ICC would be positive when both the commodities are normal goods and the slope will be an upward sloping curve. Let's take a look at the negative slope now. So this is how we will represent the negative ICC curve. We have good Y on Y axis, good X on X axis is the initial point of equilibrium. Let us say once again, the income of consumer increases. When that happens, the budget line would shift outwards. All right, so let's do that. So we've shifted the budget line outwards. We have A1 and B1. The negative ICC curve would happen when either of the commodities is inferior. In this case, good X, let me just write that down over here. Good X is an inferior good. That means good Y is a normal good. And we remember that as the income of a consumer increases, his quantity for inferior goods would fall. Why? Because consumer has become better off and he is now capable of buying more normal or superior goods. So in this case, since commodity X is an inferior good, this consumer would buy fewer goods than before. Let us say he was purchasing OX quantity of good X. Now, with an increase in income, he would want to buy lesser than before. Let us say he's purchasing OX1, which is probably somewhere over here. So we may have an indifference curve tangent at this particular point. Let us say this is IC1 and this is E1. So what has consumer done? He has reduced his consumption of commodity X. Let us say if the income of consumer rises further, in that case, once again, his quantity for inferior goods would fall. Let us shift the budget line. We should know by now where the budget line would shift. Let me name it as A2, B2. Again, because the income has increased, a consumer would want to buy yet fewer quantities of this inferior good. So let us say the consumer is now consuming only OX2 of the inferior good. The consumer may be at equilibrium at this particular point. Let me name it as IC2 and this is point E2. Now let us try and join all these equilibrium pointers. So we begin from the origin, we go here, the IC curve goes somewhere around here. So this is our ICC on a cleaner scale. This is how the curve has moved, like this. Okay, so this is a backward bending curve or backward sloping, however you may call it. All right, this is how the ICC curve would look when the commodity listed on the x-axis is an inferior good. Let us take if the commodity listed on the y-axis is an inferior good. How would the ICC curve look like? So let us now say the commodity listed on the y-axis is an inferior good and this is a normal good. Now once again, the income of consumer increases and his quantity of inferior good would fall. Let us shift the budget line first. So here is the budget line, A1, B1. Now initially a consumer was consuming OY quantity of the inferior good. As the income increases, he will buy lesser of the quantity. Let us say a consumer is buying OY1. This is less than before. And he may be at equilibrium at E1, at IC1. Now, if the income of a consumer increases further, he would further reduce his consumption of inferior goods. Let us shift the budget line once again. This is A2, B2. Let us say the consumer is now consuming only OY2, which is further lower than before, and the consumer is at equilibrium at point E2 on IC2. Now if we join all these pointers, this is how the ICC curve would slope. Extend it a bit. This is the ICC curve and it is bending towards the X axis. On a clear scale, this is how your ICC curve would look like. All right, this is how the ICC curve would behave if the commodity listed on the Y axis is an inferior good. If we pay a close attention, it will always bend towards the normal good. In this case, normal good was listed on the X axis, so it bent towards the normal good over here. And in the above case, which was X axis with the inferior good, normal good was listed on the Y axis, so it was bending towards the normal goods. Okay, so this is how the ICC curve would look like. Children, if you like my videos, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel. We are nearing the end of this series, even the advanced one. I'm going to publish the notes very soon and it will be updated on the post segments. So please keep a close tab on the posts that I make. If you find learning through long videos difficult, you could also follow my Instagram channel and learn through reels. I'll see you in another video with another topic. Bye now. Take care.